joining us this morning to blow us away yet again is the wonderful Matt Tarrant.
Yeah. Thank you for having me.
Now, tell us about your journey. You started off as a banker.
I did, yeah. So I started working at a bank and I was in a head office there in Adelaide. And at about 25 years of age, I decided I've had enough. And I walked out, and that was the end of it. Became a professional magician
since
then.
That's amazing. Our stories are so similar.
Yes. I thought of you straight away.
You said banker.
Yeah, I did say banker.
With a B, yeah. But yeah, so left the job and then decided to become a professional magician and haven't looked back since.
Wow.
So with magic, what was the big draw? Why did you go from banking to magic?
It's a good question. So I was 7 years old and I saw a magician at Adelaide Fringe. His name was Rudy Kobe, this incredible magician, and I decided at that point I wanted to be a magician.
Really?
But I think I was so young I didn't realise I could become a magician. Mm. I thought he was a wizard. Mm. So I decided just to get a normal job like most people. And then 25 years of age, saw another magician perform and went, I want to do that.
Wow.
But maybe better.
I guess banks have been making people's money disappear for many years.
Thank
you. Thank you very much indeed. God bless.
You're here all morning?
I'm here all morning and try the veal.
And you decided to go on Survivor. And you lasted over 50 days on that show, which is a hell of a... That's almost to the end.
Yes, yeah, so I finished 5th.
What was it like?
It was the hardest thing I've ever done.
Really?
It really was.
Why?
I think just the mental aspect of the game is so full on. And also just being on a reality TV show is also quite gruelling. And I don't think you realise that when you sign up. I just went on to go have a bit of fun on an island.
Yeah.
But it is so much tougher than that.
Was there ATM machines on the island?
There wasn't, no. There was no food, no water. I lost 15 kilos and it was,
I'm signing up straight away.
The next series sounds exciting too.
Celebrity Survivor. Oh, I know.
Now, tell us a bit about the Melbourne Magic Festival, is it?
Yeah, so the Melbourne Magic Festival is on right now, and that's where I'm performing. So I've got 3 more shows, 1 more tonight, and then 2 more over the weekend. So it's this great festival, just magic. So there's about 80 or so shows in Melbourne at the Melbourne Spiegel Tent, and there's just some incredible magic from all around the world that come across
Melbourne. Well, you can just rock up and catch a show.
Rock up, catch a show. They're all fairly cheap, like $20, $30 for a show. And there's so much various acts of magic and so many different styles of magic.
If I went along and I wasn't happy with the show, could I get my ticket? My tickets have gone. They've disappeared. That's magic.
Anyway, Matt, you've got some magic. Tell us about what you're doing today.
I do, yeah. I wanted to show you guys a trick while I was here. In fact, it's the hardest trick that I do. So live TV, who knows what's going to happen. Mm-hmm. But I do have a deck of cards here.
The producer just said, make Jono disappear.
It's a very special deck just for you guys. Okay.
Yes.
Now, in a deck of cards, there are 52 playing cards, 26 red and 26 black. Would you like a red card or a black card?
Ooh, red.
Red.
Yes.
You're going to go red. So in red, we have hearts and we have diamonds. Do you like a heart or a diamond?
This is getting confusing.
A heart.
Yes.
Cool. So we've got to have a heart. So in hearts, we have number cards and we have picture cards.
Yeah. Yes.
Do you want a number card or a picture card?
What do you think, audience? Do I want a picture card? Picture card,
picture.
The audience.
So a red, heart, a picture card. So Jack, Queen, King. What would you like?
Oh,
Queen.
Queen. So we're left with the Queen of Hearts. Now, we haven't set anything up, and I told you at the start this deck of cards is very special, and it is. In fact, every single playing card inside this deck is blank, except for 3 playing cards, and I hope this morning those 3 cards represent your card, which was the Queen of Hearts.
Yeah.
Wow.
Can we maybe grab some music, if we can?
Ooh, what type of music?
Yes. Here we go.
Whoa.
It's pretty dramatic for a card trick.
Yeah. Oh, that's great. It's very spiral, isn't it?
Next on Survivor.
They're all blank.
Getting excited.
your card
is. Can you just tap your fingers over those cards for me?
I'll do the loud one.
So you're saying.
Stop it!
Oh, wow.
How did you do that?
He's a wizard.
The Queen of Hearts, your card.
Matt, that is incredible! Yeah. Wow, how did you do it?
Magic. That one, yeah, that one is just sleight of hand magic. So I hope you guys enjoy that.
Let's hear it for Matt. That's amazing.
And Matt, you mentioned earlier, thank you so much for joining
us. That's okay.
That fantastic festival. Where can people find out more details in Melbourne?
Yeah, so melbournemagicfestival.com.au,
yep,
or you can get tickets at eventfinder.com.au as well. And as I said, tonight's almost sold out, as has Friday and Saturday night for my show. So if you want to come along, please do.
Matt, you know when I did the finger click?
Yeah, mate.
Was that the thing that made the magic happen?
That's it. Was
that boys and girls at home, if you click things over meals, they'll get bigger, over your parents' white wallet, that sort of thing.
It was all you. Yeah.
Matt, thanks so much for joining us this morning. Much appreciated.
Thanks so much.